Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are safe and staying at home. I congratulate and welcome all those students who have been promoted to class 9. So, I'm here to begin the first online class of English literature. I'll start with the book Treasure Trove, a collection of short stories and poems. And today, we will be doing the first poem of the book The Heart of the Tree by Henry Cuyler Bunner. So children, open your books to page number 8 and be ready with a pencil or a pen to note down the relevant points and meanings while the poem is being explained to you. So here we go. What does he plant who plants a tree? He plants a friend of sun and sky. Now to begin with, I would like to brief you with the general pattern of the poem. The general pattern followed in the poem is that of raising a question and then immediately providing an answer to that question. This technique is literally known as hypophora. So students, you may note down H-Y-P-O-P-H-O-R-A. In the poem, the poet begins each stanza of the poem with the question, what does he plant who plants a tree? And the answer given each time in every other stanza discusses the importance of trees in different spheres of human life. Now, this repetition, you would wonder why the poet is repeating the question. This repetition of the same question at the beginning of each stanza is intentionally done to create curiosity or anxiety in the readers to know more about the poem. So here we go. What does he plant who plants a tree? He plants a friend of sun and sky. Now, a person who is planting a tree, what does he actually do? The poet wants to know from the readers that the person who is planting a tree, what is he actually trying to do? And the answer is given by the poet himself, and he says he plants a friend of sun and sky. A friend of sun, children, you may underline a friend of sun. Now tree is a friend of sun because tree utilizes the sunlight by the process of photosynthesis and prepares food, and it is a friend of the sky in the sense that we get rain from the clouds that are there in the sky, and that helps the trees to carry on the process of transpiration. So a friend of sun due to the process of photosynthesis, and a friend of sky due to the process of transpiration. Now, there are further more things that a planter does. He plants the flag of breezes free. Now, a planter who plants trees is actually planting trees which give out branches, and the leaves on the branches of those trees sway along with the breeze, and they appear to be like flags. The shaft of beauty towering high. Now here the tree has been compared to a shaft of beauty. So children, underline the word shaft. Shaft means a column. So because the tree grows tall, it is towering high. It grows tall like a tower, and so it looks very beautiful. So in other words, the poet plants a tree which is like a beautiful tower rising high. He plants a home to heaven and I. Underline the words heaven and anai. Now heaven, you all know, place of God. And anai means close to. So he, by planting a tree, he is actually planting a home which is closer to heaven. Now the tree grows so tall that it seems to be close to the sky, or in other words, it seems to be close to heaven. for song and mother croon of bird in hushed and happy twilight heard. And as the poet plants, as the planter plants the tree, it helps the mother bird to sit on it and sing beautiful song to its babies in hushed and happy twilight. Hushed means in the silence of the night and also at the time of twilight. Now see students, at the time of twilight, now twilight is, I'm sure you all know what twilight is, and if you don't, twilight is actually the faint light which it can be seen at the time the sun goes down. So at the time of twilight, the mother bird sings sweet songs to its babies during the silence of the night. The treble of heaven's harmony, these things he plants who plants a tree. By planting a tree, a poet provides harmony to the entire universe. It seems as if it is establishing harmony with the universe. And these are the things that he plants who plants a tree. So children, we are through with the first stanza of the poem, The Heart of the Tree. So in this stanza, the various benefits of planting a tree have been clearly depicted by the poet. Now we move to the next stanza. What does he plant who plants a tree? So this is again a reminder to you, a question asked by the poet to the readers and the answer is given by the poet himself. This technique is called hypophora. A person who plants a tree plants cool shade and tender rain. Trees, they provide a lot of shade during the bright sunshine and during the day hours. And tree also provides gentle rain to the earth and seed on buds of days to be. So children, here you may underline days to be. Days to be means future. So by planting a tree, a planter is actually providing seeds and buds for the future generation, because once we plant a tree, it grows and gives fruits and flowers, and the fruits again have seeds in them which in turn again grow into another tree. And so this is how the cycle moves on. And years that fade and flush again. You may underline fade and flush. Now here the poet is trying to imply that a planter who plants trees provides seeds for future generation, and these trees grow and provide further seeds and buds, and in years as the time passes the trees fade and flush, they die. He plants the glory of the plain. You children, you may write another phrase for fade and flush, and that is the old trees wither away and new trees grow. He plants the glory of the plain. Besides this, another benefit of planting trees is that he is providing a glorious atmosphere to the entire Mother Earth. He plants the forest's heritage. Now by planting trees, he is actually planting the entire forest. One tree will give out fruits and seeds, and they further develop into trees, and so this goes on. The harvest of a coming age. Now, by planting trees, the poet is providing crops to the future generation. The joy that unborn eyes shall see. Now, children, please underline the word unborn. And I'm sure you people know the meaning of the word joy. If not, it is happiness. And the happiness that the future generation or the children that are yet to be born, he is trying to plant all those things. He is trying to plant trees, and thus he provides happiness to the future generation, the children who are yet to be born. And these are the things that he plants. So these are various benefits of planting a tree. Now we move to the third stanza, where the poet will tell us about some more benefits of planting a tree. It again begins with the technique hypophora. What does he plant who plants a tree? He plants in sap and leaf and wood. Underline the word sap. It means carrier of food. So by planting a tree, he is actually providing leaves, wood, and also a tree which is a carrier of food. In love of home and loyalty. And why is he doing this? He's doing this because he loves his country, he loves his home, and he is very faithful to his nation. And far cast thought of civic good. Now, civic good here refers to the well-being of the citizens. So a planter plants a tree because in his mind he can foresee the well-being of the citizens. He's not just planting a tree, but also providing benefit to the entire city. His blessings on the neighborhood, who in the hollow of his hand holds all the growth of all our land. Now you may notice one thing, that in this line, the word his is written with a capital H. Here, his would refer to God. It is actually his blessings means here the blessings of the planter who has got God-like qualities. So his blessings on the neighborhood, by planting a tree, he's actually blessing the entire neighborhood, the neighbors living, you know, close to him, and who in the hollow of his hand. The hollow is the empty part of one's hand. So this planter in the empty part of his hand actually holds the entire growth of his entire nation. A nation's growth from sea to sea stirs in his heart who plants a tree. And a planter is just not doing this particular job of planting a tree just for the sake of planting a tree, but he's actually trying to provide a growth to his entire nation, and rather from one end to the other. From sea to sea here means from one end to the other. And this feeling of providing benefit to the entire world actually stirs in his heart, actually keeps moving in his heart, in the heart of one who plants a tree. So he plants a tree for the survival of future generation. He plants trees so that human beings can get food from the sap and the leaves. So the poet, through this poem, tells the readers about the crucial importance of trees for our survival. This is the main theme of the poem. Besides, the poem also brings forward the poet's concern about the future of the earth. It seems as if the poet could see the impending destruction and thus indirectly appeals to the readers to plant trees not only for themselves but also for the future generation. So students, if you're asked to write down the theme of the poem, you could very well say that the poet deals with the two themes that can be brought out in the poem, and they are importance of trees for our survival and concern for the future of the earth. So this is all about the poem. I hope you all have understood it well and have noted down the relevant points and the meanings. In the next class, we'll deal with certain questions which will be extract-based questions based on the poem, The Heart of the Tree. So students, please prepare yourselves well till the next class. See you again.